So see, the question was let's start with question number third, because question number third was we need to find only maximum and minimum value, right? So question three was fx was x plus 1 by x, right? And we need to find local minima and local maxima. Why did I say only local and minima and maxima? Why didn't I say find out the minima and maxima?
Sir, because it can infinity or infinity.
Yes, because if I take my x equal to infinity, the function will go to infinity. And if I take x as a minus infinity, the function will go to minus infinity. So obviously the maxima and minimum value of that function will be infinity and minus infinity. But I am not interested in infinity. I am interested in the value. So what I will do, first I will differentiate it. So what is the procedure to get maxima and minima? First of all, we will differentiate the function, right? This is the standard procedure, right? So yes. What the will be the f dash x, the differentiation, of x is 1, right? And differentiation of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. Okay?
Yes, sir.
And after that, what we'll do? We will make f dash x equal to 0. So I will make it 0. So I will get x equal to plus minus 1, right? At x equal to plus minus 1, f dash s is becoming 0. So now I will differentiate it again, f of double dash x. So what will come?
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, why are we differentiating it again? Can you explain that part?
Yes. So now I'm checking that at which point I'm going to get maxima or minima. So if you remember, if f double dash x is get it is coming with the positive value, that means the function will have minima over there. And if f or double dash x is having negative value, that means the function is going to have maximum value of that point. If you don't want to do it, it's okay. See, what are my critical points? Batao. 1 and minus 1. So I will get value. F of minus 1 is minus 1 minus 1 by 1. So that is minus 2. And f of 1 is 1 plus 1 by 1. So it will become 2. So now you will know na ki batao iske andar maxima kya hai minima kya hai.
Sir, minus 1 will be maxima.
Minus 2 is minima. Minus 2 is maxima, 2 is minima.
Minus 2 is... Aray, nahin, nahin, nahin. Aray, this is the value of function. So you can check na ki minus 2 chota hota hai ya 2 chota hota hai. I am talking about the value of function. See, this is value of function. I am putting value in function, not f dash x. So this is value of function.
Yeah, so 2 is maximum, minus 2 is.
Yes, so I don't have to do all this stuff. If I want to recheck it, so okay, so f double dash x will come out to be, tell me, 1 is 0 and it will come out to be 2 upon x cube, right?
Yes, sir.
Now you can put the value. See, f double dash x of minus 1, it will comes out to be
minus 2.
Negative. F of plus 1 will comes out to be positive. So now you can see. These are my critical points. I am interested in these points. And what is the value of at this point? Is this. Okay. Fine. How does the graph look like of x equal to x plus 1 by x? Is the graph kaisa hoga?
If we put minus one and it comes negative, so doesn't that mean that it should be maxima?
Yes. Okay, now I will show you the graph. See? Okay. When my x is positive, so the function's value will be positive because my x will always be positive and 1 by x will also be positive. Fine? When the value of x is 0, or you can say approaching to 0. So what will be the value of my fx? Suppose my x is 0. So the first term will become 0 and the second term will become what? 1 by 0 is what?
Infinite.
So my function will come from infinite. And when the x is value is infinite, then what will it come? Infinite and 1 by infinite is 0. So the function ko yahan se aana hai aur yahan jana hai. Okay, so the function will come like this. This value is this point is 1. And here the value is 2. So this is minima. Okay. I'm not talking about the global. I am talking about local. Now tell me the graph. What will happen when the value of x is negative? When x is negative, my fx will also be negative, na? Yes. Be negative, ye be negative. So everything will be negative. So the graph will come here, something like this. Okay. Graph will come something like this. This point is what? X equal to minus 1. So ye kya ban gaya? Aur ye kya ban gaya? This is minima, this is
maxima.
So I told you when we get f double dash x negative, to mere paas kya aata hai?
Maxima.
And when I get f double dash x positive, I get minima. So the graph will look like this, approximately, because I'm not perfect that every point will be, you know, I just made the graph with the free hand. So yeah. Everyone,
yes, sir.
Any doubt?
So I'm not getting that.
Which part?
So means that I got that differentiation and all, but afterwards that how to draw it means.
How to draw?
How we are getting the values of means f double dash minus one plus one and all.
Because these are the critical points. I told you now, what are the critical points? When f dash is 0. Wherever f dash x is 0, something is going to happen there. Either maxima, minima, or something like this. Okay? So I'm interested in that. Because at that point, curve will change. Either it will go down or it will go up. Okay? So that is why I'm interested in those points. So I check that what are the critical points. So from this equation, I got that x equal to plus minus 1 are the critical points. Okay. I got the value of function at critical point. I get minus 2 and 2. But now I have to see ki kaun sa maxima, kaun sa minima. So what did I do? I differentiated again. F double dash x. What will it come out? The differentiation of 1 is 0 and 1 by x square will become 2 by x cube. Now I put my critical point here. So the value will come what? When I put minus 1, it will come minus. Okay, negative value. That means at x equal to minus 1, see, this is my x equal to minus 1. I am getting point of maxima. Obviously, maxima hai. Because the nearby guy are having lesser value. So So this is point of maxima. So I can say point A is maxima, point B is minima. You can check it again. I'll give you the function. Suppose my function was, second function kya tha? Sin x plus cos x. Huh? Okay, how many of you have solved this? What is the maximum value of this function?
Sir, I got it as pi by 4 or 45 degrees.
No. You will get maximum value at 45 degrees. Yeah. But yeah, what is the maximum value?
So, I think what is the maximum for maxima. So that's why I didn't.
Yes. So see, this is my function. First, I will do what? Differentiate f dash x. So it will comes out with sine ka derivative. Cos ka derivative. Minus sine. Now, what will I do? To get critical points, I will put f dash x equal to 0. To mere paas kya aa jayega? Sin x equal to cos x. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
तो इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? साइन एक्स और कॉस एक्स की वैल्यू इक्वल कब होती है? 45 डिग्री पे होती है ना?
यस सर.
है ना?
यस.
सो आई विल गेट, तो एफ डबल डैश एक्स चेक करने की जरूरत ही नहीं, ऐसे आ जाएगा, डायरेक्ट आ जाएगा ना. आई विल नो दैट एक्स इज आइदर पाई बाई फोर और एक्स इक्वल टू कितना, पाई प्लस पाई बाई फोर. बताया ये कंपाउंड एंगल पाई इन द थर्ड क्वाड्रेंट साइन ये हो जाता है. तो कोई बात नहीं, अगर तुमको वो करना नहीं है तो कोई बात नहीं, बस इतना ही काफी है. तो एक्स इक्वल टू पाई बाई फोर, तो मेरे पास में क्या आएगा मैक्सिमम वैल्यू एफ एक्स मैक्सिमम
सर
साइन 45 डिग्री प्लस कॉस 45 डिग्री, तो क्या बन जाएगा? √2 और 1/√2 plus 1/√2. Clear? Anyone has some doubt in this?
No, sir.
If you want to draw the graph, we will make a small graph only. When x is 0, what is the value of function? 0 and 1. So the value will become 1. When x is pi by 4, function ka value kya hai? Root 2. Yahan pe kahin aayega na, root 2 upar hota hai. Root 2 is a greater than 1. Then the value is pi by 2. To kya ban jayega? Sin pi by 2 is 1, cos pi by 2 is
0,
1. To hamara jo graph hai wo kuch aisa aa jayega. देखो, दिस इज माय पॉइंट ऑफ मैक्सिमा. क्लियर? हाँ भाई.
यस सर.
एनीवन सम डाउट और समथिंग?
सो द मिनिमा विल कम आउट टू बी एट
माइनस टू.
माइनस रूट टू, राइट?
माइनस रूट टू, बिकॉज साइन एंड कॉस फंक्शन आर पीरियडिक फंक्शन ना.
Yes,
उनकी वैल्यू पूरा प्लस माइनस में होती है. तो अभी तुमको वो एंगल नहीं पता, इसलिए मैंने आगे नहीं बताया. तो एक बार के लिए इतना काफी है. थर्ड फंक्शन वाज, क्या था फंक्शन? एक्स एफ एक्स इक्वल टू एक्स अपॉन एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 90. ओके, दिस वन और ऊपर वाला
नहीं, सही यही वाला.
ओके, लास्ट वन किस किस ने किया?
ओके सर, हो गया.
ट्राई किया सर, मुझे आया नहीं कोई मैक्सिमा या मिनिमा.
क्यों, ऐसे कैसे नहीं आया?
पता नहीं सर, रॉन्ग किया है इस बाद में.
तो नहीं तो पहले बताओ इसका का डिफरेंशिएशन कैसे किया
सर? फर्स्ट वाले प्रॉब्लम का ना, sin x + cos x का नहीं सर, ये वाला हो गया.
नहीं नहीं, हां इसी की बात कर रहा हूं मैं. अच्छा, वाला ये
इसका हमारा डिफरेंशिएशन आया x square plus 9 raised to 3 by 2 into 1 मतलब वही minus x into सब वो explain मतलब थोड़ा difficult है 3x
okay you tell me the steps when I will solve f dash x I will tell so first whenever you want to find maxima or minima of any function first of all you should remember the step f dash x hame function ka derivative find karna hai and we have to make that derivative equal to zero and after that we will get a critical point and we will check the critical point then it's fine f dash x यहाँ पे देर आर टू फंक्शन वन फंक्शन इज इन द न्यूमिनेटर वन इज द डिनोमिनेटर तो क्या लगाएंगे कौन सा रूल लगेगा
सर क्वोशेंट रूल
क्वोशेंट रूल क्या होता है क्वोशेंट रूल
सर
पहले जो भी
डिफरेंशिएशन
इसका स्क्वायर कर देते हैं इसका स्क्वायर कर देते हैं ना डिनोमिनेटर का तो
x² + 9 होल क्यूब हो जाता है बस या
यस ये है इसका होल स्क्वायर आफ्टर दैट आई विल पुट डिनोमिनेटर एज इट इज एंड आई विल डिफरेंशिएट द अबव फंक्शन ओके देन आई विल पुट अ माइनस साइन आई विल पुट अबव फंक्शन एज इट इज एंड आई विल डेरिवेटिव द डिनोमिनेटर राइट एवरीवन ऑल नोज दिस यहां तक हो गया सबसे
Yes, sir.
किस किस से यहां तक नहीं हुआ वॉज नॉट एबल टू गेट दिस स्टेप अनिरुद्ध अनिरुद्ध सीवुड अंशुल
yes, sir.
बताओ बेटा यहां तक हो गया था
yes, sir.
Okay. धनंजय
यस सर
यू गॉट दिस स्टेप
यस सर
ओके गुड हाँ ओके आफ्टर दैट वी विल सिंपलीफाई इट सो एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस ये यहाँ पे क्या हो जाएगा एक्स का डेरिवेटिव क्या होता है वन सो दैट स्टेप विल एज इट इज एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 9 की पावर 3 बाय 2 माइनस एक्स हियर वी विल अप्लाई चेन रूल First of all, we are looking the power 3 by 2. So what is the derivative of power 3 by 2? 3 by 2, whatever is inside, iska power half. Because we have to subtract 1 from 3 by 2. Then, x square plus 9 ka derivative kya ho jayega? X square ka derivative. 2x and x 9 ka 0. And whole upon x square plus 9 ki power 3. Aur hume is cheez ko equal to kya karna hai? जीरो क्योंकि हम तो एफ डैश एक्स को जीरो करते हैं ना तो इफ आई वांट टू मेक इट जीरो तो मुझे डिनोमिनेटर को अपने जीरो करना है ना बस नहीं न्यूमिरेटर को तो यहां से देखो मेरे पास एक्सप्रेशन बनेगा एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 9 की पावर 3 बाई 2 माइनस इस 2 से ये 2 गया और ये बन जाएगा 3x स्क्वायर एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 9 की पावर हाफ इक्वल टू जीरो अब क्या करोगे x square plus 9 की पावर हाफ कॉमन ले लो यहां से क्या बचेगा x square plus 9 की पावर 1 यहां से बचेगा 3x square equal to 0 this quantity cannot be 0 because my x square is also positive 9 is also positive this can be negative so when I will make it 0 it will become 9 equal to 2x square तो x equal to क्या बन जाएगा 9 by 2 plus minus तो I can say plus minus 3 by root 2 one time I can put minus one time I can put plus so I can obviously see because in the denominator you are getting x square so it does not matter whether I put positive value or negative value. And in the numerator, if I put positive value, I will get the positive value. If I get the negative value, I will get the negative value. Okay. So now let's put the graph, make the graph. So when the value of x is positive, so the function will be a positive or negative? See, look at the graph and tell me. When the value of x is positive, so kya hoga graph? I have fx as x upon x square plus 9 ki power 3 by 2. Batao bhi. When x is 0, what is fx?
Sir,
hi everyone, is quiet. Arya, Athar, Bhumi.
Yes.
When x is 0, what is the value of fx?
0.
Zero.
Zero, na yaar. Zero. I will start from here. Okay. And when x is positive, then the whole function will be positive?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then x is a negative. Suppose my x, the value of x is infinite. So the function will approach to
infinite
or zero? No.
So zero. In the, up on x, yeah.
Yes. In the denominator, you are having x square, so x square is bigger. Okay, the function will come here, and I am getting, I have to start from zero and I have to go down to zero, so somewhere I will go up. So I will get maxima at what point? 3/√2. So the function will be something like this. This is x equal to 3/√2. Okay, and when my x is a negative, so the whole thing will become negative. So it all things will be like this.
Yes, sir.
This is x is minus 3/√2. Okay, sabko same rahega. So this is maxima. This is minima. I don't have to do a double derivative again and again. I don't need it actually. I can draw the graph, and in the graph I can see the things. I don't have to prove anything because I can see everything, that what point is maximum or what point is minimum.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, how will we know where we need to do double derivative and where not?
Beta, when you can draw the graph, na? Okay.
Yes.
Then you don't have to do double derivative. Or when, see, my differentiation is so complicated. If I make that and double differentiate, it will be very complicated. So in that situation, avoid. If the function is very easy, then you can do. Okay. So if you can draw the graph, it's fine. You can draw it. You will obviously see the values. You don't have to do a double derivative. So that is why I'm saying drawing the graph is the important part rather than single derivative or a double derivative. These are just helping tools. Okay. Clear how to get a minima and maxima of functions.
Can you scroll down a bit?
If you have any questions, you can ask. Anyone has any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. Now the other complicated thing comes. We have to find maxima or minima. Okay. But function is not given. Function is not given. Iska matlab kya hua? We have to create the function. So first we have to create the function and then we have to find the maxima and minima. So now there is, you can say, a double struggle for you guys. They will give you just a statement, and on the statement of that thing, you have to find the maxima. How? Just an example. Suppose you are asked, if there is a circle, or you can say disk of radius r, we need to cut out a rectangle from it, find maximum area of that rectangle. Now just read the statement. Statement kya bol raha hai? Huh?
So we have to find the maximum area of a rectangle that can be fitted into the circle.
Suppose this is the disk, or you can say circle. And now I have to cut a rectangle. So there are so many possibilities of a rectangle, right? See, I can cut this. This is a rectangle. Okay, I want to maximize the area. Suppose that this is a pizza, and someone asks you, okay, that okay, you can have pizza, but that should be in the shape of a rectangle. Now you want to eat the maximum pizza, then you have to do your calculation. Okay, at what side, how much I have to cut? Okay, if you will come here, okay, it will be like this. There's so many possibilities, right? Infinite possibilities are there, right?
Yes, sir.
So I need to find the maximum area. So now you have to create your function by yourself. Function bhi khud ko create karna hai.
Yes, sir.
And you have to find the area also. So this is the challenging part. Confused? Okay. Now give me idea. How do I solve it? You want to eat the maximum part of the pizza. Now you should learn our differentiation. How will you eat that? Ideas.
Sir, can we
yes. Sir, rectangle circle ke andar karne ki jagah rectangle ke andar circle.
Nahi yaar, tum bahar kaise kar doge? Pizza to andar hai pura. Maine tumko bola hai na, you have to take out square piece from the circle. Tumne to pure question ko hi change kar
diya. So we can maybe draw a graph of length into breadth and find the maxima.
Yes, that is the whole idea. See, you have to check, find maximum area. So first of all, I need to find a function of area. Then I will maximize it. So I will just draw a rectangle like this. Okay. What is the property of a rectangle?
Yes, sir.
Kya property hoti hai?
Can we say that the length diagonal of the rectangle will be diameter of the circle?
Yes, because I want my rectangle to be a biggest. Yes, है ना? So if my rectangle जो है उसका जो biggest जो अपना diagonal है वो क्या हो सकता है? उसका diameter इससे बड़ा तो हो ही नहीं सकता ना?
Yes sir. So Pythagoras use कर सकते हैं L
square. Yes, yes, we'll use Pythagoras. Good. So we have to come up with an idea. So see, suppose this is my rectangle and I know that this angle is 90 degree in the rectangle. All the angles are 90 degree. Suppose this angle is theta. So I just put, what is this side? This side is 2R. Okay, tell me, what will be this side? This one is L, this side is B. So I will make it a right angle triangle. So right angle triangle will be like this.
So sir, we can get a equation like 4R square is equal to L square plus B square.
Yes. So I will say 2R. This is 2R. This is L. This is B. So tell me, what is sine theta in this triangle? B by 2R. Yes. So B will become 2R sine theta. Same. What I will say, what is cos theta? L by 2R. L will become 2R.
Cos theta.
Cos theta. Now I know both the sides of a rectangle. So what is the area of rectangle? L into B?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So now you find area. So this is L. This is B. Kya ho jayega area?
The 4R square sine theta cos theta.
4R square sine theta cos theta. Now I have to find maxima of this function. So tell me, किसी भी function का maxima कैसे निकालते हैं?
So differentiated.
Differentiate करके उसको zero कर देंगे.
Zero कर देना, yes sir.
Okay, now I have to see what is the variable in the equation. Theta. Theta is the variable, na? Because if I make, you know, different this, so my angle will be different, right? See?
Yes,
theta
sir.
Theta 1,
angle you can get
theta 2,
area, so.
Theta 3. So I have to differentiate with respect to theta. So it will become 4R square. Yeah, yahan pe kya lagaoge? There are two functions which are in multiplication.
Yes, sir. So
I will say sine theta,
theta
by cos theta. Okay. Then plus cos theta d theta by d theta sine theta. So it will become 4R square. Kya hota cos theta ka?
Minus sine theta. Sine square theta.
Yeah. So minus sine square theta. It will become plus cos square theta. And I will put it equal to zero. F dash x, I need to put zero. That means sine square theta should be equal to cos square theta. That means sine theta equal to cos theta. That means theta equal to 45 degrees.
L and B are equal. So
it's yes. Now I can say in the result. So first I will say maximum the area hai, it will become 4R square 1 by root 2. So it will become 2R square. And I will say it will be a square. So this is how I will solve. First, you have to convert. See, first you have to convert the statement into the form of equation. Okay. And after that, you will do what? Differentiate.
differentiated and like equal to zero.
Yes.
Yes. So could you just give me 1 minute to copy it?
Yeah. Okay. Anyone else?
Can you scroll up? But...
Yeah, I'll scroll up. But tell me, what's the question? Any problem? Because see, in the in real life, you will get example like this only.
So how did we know that it is a square?
Because I'm getting theta equal to 45 degree, na? So you can check my length and breadth are same, because length is 2r cos theta, breadth is 2r sin theta.
Okay.
So at 45 degree, sin theta and cos theta are same. So a special rectangle which has both the side equal is square. Yes.
Yes, I just want. Yes, I done.
Okay, I'll give you one question. You guys also try. And tell me, what is the formula for volume? Volume of a cuboid. Kya hota hai?
LBH.
LBH.
Yes, LBH hota hai. So, okay. I'm giving you one sheet. Okay. A square sheet is given to you. The side is L. One L cross L sheet is given to you. Now, what you are doing, you are making a, you know, something like to hold the water. So what you will do, you will cut it out like this. See? Suppose. Yes, I know. You cut this like this from all the, you fold it. You fold it like this. Or isko aise upar kar doge. तो तुम्हारा एक वो बन जाएगा ना, बॉक्स बन जाएगा ना. सपोज यू हैव वन पीस ऑफ एन पेपर एंड फ्रॉम ऑल द कॉर्नर यू जस्ट फोल्ड इट अप, तो एक स्पेस बन जाएगा ना, बॉक्स टाइप का, ड्रॉअर टाइप का.
यस सर.
यस. सो जितना मैं यहां से इसको ये करूंगा, फोल्ड करूंगा, उतनी उसकी हाइट बन जाएगी ना हर तरफ से.
यस सर.
ओके. सो you have to fold it from all four sides to make it an empty box. Yes, it will become the empty box. Fine. Maximum volume of that empty box. उस बॉक्स का वॉल्यूम मुझे मैक्सिमाइज करना है. सो हाउ विल आई डू दैट? सपोज if you will increase the height, so your base area will be reduced, right? And if you reduce the height, your base area will be max, but your height will be less, so your volume will become zero. So now tell me, how will you do it?
So can I try and tell you the answer in 2 minutes?
Yes. I'm giving you time. You just think for 2 minutes. All guys, think. You, if you want, you can take one paper out of your copy and you can, you know, make it. And you can feel that, okay, if I will increase the height, my base area will be reduced. So my volume will be less. Okay. So you can feel it. Then you can make the equation. And then you use the differentiation.
It's a square, right? Like both.
Yeah. See, all the four height has to be same, na? Agar height same nahi, toh fir what is the point? You will fill the water and it will come out. So height should be same. So that is why I have given you that the square sheet is given.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Yeah, anyone?
Yes, so 1 second.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, the equation will be L minus X into L minus X into X.
L minus X or beta L minus 2X?
2X, right? Yeah.
See, you are folding it from both hand, right?
Yes, sir.
Suppose... Yes, you are making the height as suppose X. So if you will cut X from all the sides, now this thing, that shaded part, it will go up, right? So if this will go up, then the remaining thing will become L minus 2x and the height will become x. So my volume will become what? Volume V will become L minus 2x ka square into x.
So sir, this is my... for... huh? So just asking for, like, I found an answer if it is correct. So x is equal to L by 2.
No, beta. X equal to L by 2 cannot be the answer, because if you will put X equal to L by 2, your volume will become zero. See in the equation.
Yes, sorry, sir.
So it cannot be in maximum. Huh? Okay. So now we have to find this function. Ka
got it. Maximum. Sir, I got two values, but so.
Sir. No, there will be only one value. There cannot be two value.
So like the other one will be minima, right, sir? So I'm just checking with.
See, one. See, minima I know. What is minima?
Zero.
Zero. Zero. I will make such a box jiske andar kuch aayega hi nahi. Zero. So either my x equal to zero or x equal to L by 2.
Okay, sir. So I got x equal to L by 6 and x equal to L by 2.
हाँ, so at x equal to L by 2, you can see ना, अगर तुम दोनों ही साइड से L by 2 ऊपर ले जाओगे, so what will be the base area? Zero.
Zero.
So if you don't right. have, if you don't have the base area, then your volume will be zero. Okay.
Yes. So L by 6 is an answer.
Yes. Okay. Now you have to find out differentiated function. So V dash. Okay. Tell me, how will you do it? X. So there are two functions, no? 1 and 2. So first I will put L minus 2x ka square. And what is the derivative of x? Then I put x as d by dx of L minus 2x ka square. So L minus 2x, what is 1 plus x. The derivative of this is 2 times L minus 2x. And what is the derivative of L minus 2x? Minus 2. Okay, now I will take common L minus 2x. I will take common, so this will become 1. Okay, minus, okay, this is square na, square, so it will become L minus 2x, and here will become minus 2 4x equal to 0. Now I will say L equal to 2x, that means x equal to L by 2, but this will leads to volume 0. Okay, and the other one will comes out to be L equal to 6x, that means x equal to L by 6. Kya aega volume if I put x equal to L by 6? Are you tell me?
Yes.
X sir. Equal to, so it will become L minus L by 3, 2 L by 3. So 4 L by 9, 4 L by 9 into
L by 6.
This. So 4 L by 9 into L by 6. So L by 2, 6, so 2 by, by 2 yeah. by 27.
Yes.
L cube.
Yeah.
So yeah. 2 by 27 L cube. So this is my maxima. Fine? Anyone? Doubts? Confusion? See, these are in real life and problems. You can now, I'm going to relate ki yaar humne differentiation kyun kiya tha, humne isliye kiya tha, so that we figure out that how things work. Okay, you want more? One more you try. Okay, first tell me, What is the formula for volume of sphere? क्या होता है?
4/3
pi r cube.
Volume of sphere is 4/3 pi r. Volume of cone?
1/3 pi r square h.
Pi r square h, right? ये होता है?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, I have one sphere of radius r. Suppose one sphere of ice cream and the radius of that sphere is r. अब मैंने तुमको बोला कि okay, you can cut it, but you have to eat the ice cream in the cone shape only. You can take out a cone. Now, obviously, you want to eat the maximum ice cream. So now tell me, what will be the maximum volume of the cone which you can take out? Okay, solve it.
Okay, sir.
Maximum ice cream you want to eat. Okay, so if you are ice cream lovers, you'll solve it. You'll do something. This cone you will take out. See, if you will increase the height of the cone, your base area will be reduced. And if you want to increase the base area, your height will be reduced. So at some point of time, you have to make some compromise. This is origin O. Solve it. Find maximum volume of cone that can be taken out. Yeah, Archit. Archit. Open your mic. Unmute yourself. Yeah, anyone got the answer?
No, sir, still trying.
Okay, how did you approach?
I'm trying to equate the cone's height to something like the radius of the sphere.
No, see, I am start from here. The obviously the height will pass through the center. So see, I'll come here. So from point A to O, this is R.
Yes.
And R is constant, I know. Okay. But the remaining things, this height is a variable. So I will say this height is H. Okay. And this length, BO, is also R. Fine. So can you get the radius? This is the radius of the cone. This radius is supposed small r. So what is the relation between capital R, small h and small r? You can say this is the right angle triangle. So I can say r square equal to h square plus r square. Okay. So for cone, height is what? R plus
H.
Radius.
So,
kya hai radius? Root R square minus H square. I need to make the equation in single variable. Now I have single variable. Now I will put formula of volume. So kya hota volume abhi bataya tha? 1 by 3 pi R square. So R square minus H square into R plus H, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now you can solve it. Now there's a function and then a variable. Kya hai isme?
R.
H. Are R is the radius of the sphere. Hai na? R is constant. R is the radius of the sphere. H is constant. And only H is there. So now what you will do, if function suppose volume, so V dash. So 1 by 3 pi. क्या करोगे? There are two functions which are in multiplication. How do you solve it? So first R square plus R square minus H square I put D by DH of R plus H minus R plus H I'll keep D by DH of R square minus H square.
Or plus. Not minus.
Okay. 1 by 3 pi. Now tell me, R is constant, it will become 0. Or DH by DH is 1. So R square minus H square plus R plus H. What will be the derivative of R square? 0, because R is constant.
Yes,
what is the derivative of H? Minus 2H. Now you have to make it 0. So you will get R square minus H square. Plus nahi, minus aa jayega na, because minus is there. Minus 2 h r and aage minus 2 h square equal to 0. So it will become 3 h square minus 2 h r plus r square equal to 0. Quadratic. फैक्टराइज करना आता है. सो यू कैन से 3h स्क्वायर माइनस
माइनस 3hr प्लस
hr प्लस hr प्लस r स्क्वायर इक्वल टू 0. सो यू विल कॉमन 3h तो h माइनस r ओके प्लस एक सेकेंड ये कैसे हो गया. There has to be some minus.
Minus 3x square.
Yes, sir. Minus 3x square, na? So minus 3x square. So you will take common minus, so it will become plus. And here you can take r. So this is h plus r equal to 0. So you will get h plus r, r minus 3h equal to 0. H plus r cannot be 0. Because height is always positive, r is also positive, so this will become 0. So height will become h will become r by 3. So that means at h equal to r by 3 you will get maximum volume. So what will be the maximum volume? 1 by 3 pi. Now you have to find the height. See, so height kya ban jayega yahan pe? कौन का r प्लस r बाई थ्री कितना बन जाएगा? 4r बाई थ्री. एंड व्हाट विल बी द रेडियस? r बाई थ्री इफ यू विल पुट हियर, r बाई थ्री इफ यू विल पुट हियर,
तो r स्क्वायर बाय 9 व्हिच इज 8 स्क्वायर बाय 9 आई गेस
1 माइनस 1 बाय 9 तो इट विल बी रूट 8 बाय 3 r राइट.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now you can find the volume. Now you know the height, you know the radius. Everything is fine. So a half. What is the radius? Root 8 by 9. Kya tha? R. And the height was? Height kya tha?
R by 3.
R by 3 nahi beta. R plus R by 3. तो h का वैल्यू आया है
4r by 3.
दिस इज h. कौन का हाइट कितना आया टोटल? r plus r by 3 ना, 4r by 4r by 3. सो दिस इज द वॉल्यूम. वॉल्यूम इज 4 root 8 upon 81 है ना, पाई r क्यूब. दिस इज द मैक्सिमम वॉल्यूम ऑफ द कोन यू कैन टेक आउट. Now someone was asking me, sir, why are we solving these kind of questions? Are they going to come in the exam? Okay, how many of you have that doubt?
See, they will not ask such question in the exam directly, but there will be one, you know, statement. Suppose they will make a question of electric field. Okay. Suppose there is a ring and a particle is moving on the axis. So find out the point where the electric field is maximum. So you should know all the geometry, cone, sphere, ring, because when you will find a gravitation field, electric field, so that charge and mass, that can be in any form. It can be in form of sphere, it can be in form of ring, disk, anything. So that is why we are studying all the structures.
Sir, what is the radius?
Yes.
What did we get the radius?
Radius of what?
Sir, of this cone. Can you scroll up?
Yes. Radius, see, I got my h equal to r by 3. So yes, now, sir, I will put this into here. And this. R square minus h square. So what is the value of my h square? R square by 9. So it will become 9 r square minus 1 into r square. So it will become root 3. Any root 8 by 3.
So then when we are squaring it, when we are squaring the radius in the volume, then shouldn't be 8 upon 9 instead of root, yes, 8 upon 9?
Are 8 upon 9 aana chahiye. Yes. The
okay,
root,
sir,
will go off. So the root will go off. So it will become
32.
Okay.
32 by, yeah.
Yes. Cool. Now you are able to find maximum minima of functions if I give you statement.
Yes, sir. I guess so, yeah.
So can you scroll up?
Scroll up.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Done.
Yes, sir.
So, suppose I give you one more question. Suppose and minus. I'm not taking that question. Okay, leave it. So sometimes what happens? There's one more thing that is called the rate of change. Have you heard the name? Rate of change. Rate. This word rate, this means time. With respect to time. Suppose if I say dx by dt or come to left, dy by dx. What does that mean? Dy by dx. Is what?
Sir, it is the difference in y.
No. This is change in y with respect to
change
x,
in
right? The change in y upon change in x. So, okay. But if I make that a denominator as t, so if I say dx by dt, so what it will become? Change in x upon change in
time,
because small t is
you know, standard out notification for time. So this is called rate of change of x. We use a special word for, you know, that time t. And what is that dx by dt? X is a position. So final position minus initial position, kya hota, displacement?
Yes, sir. So displacement upon time, which means
time. What is that? Velocity. So rate of change is also we study in, you can say, a differentiation. Just suppose, example. Suppose I have a square sheet. And the side of square sheet is A. So for what is the area? A square?
Yes. Right?
Now, if I will increase the side, suppose I increase the side like this. By dA.
But with respect to time?
Yes. Suppose the sheet is expanding because of the heat. So, batao, iska area change hoega?
Yes, sir.
Yes, see, now the area has changed. So, this. So, if I ask you how much area has changed, so that is only the shaded part. Because A square was the initial area, and what is the initial area that has come into the picture? The shaded part. So that shaded part is called dA. Kya matlab hua dA ka matlab? Change in area. Because capital A is area. So now suppose you are given the rate of change of side and someone asks you what is the rate of change of area. Then how will you solve it? So we use a differentiation. Like, suppose function is given a. A is a square. Function hota hai ye. Right? Now you are differentiate this function with respect to a. So what will you get?
2a.
dA by dA equal to 2a. So it will become dA will become 2a into dA. Now if I divide this by dt, I can divide. So ye kya hai?
So change in area with respect to time.
Rate of change of area, and this is rate of
change of change in area.
Side. So this is the relation. So in this manner you can make formula for everything, like for sphere. Suppose you are blowing the air in a balloon. Okay. So kya hoga? If you blow the air in the balloon, to kya hoga? Jo bhi hamara balloon ka size hai, apna increase hoga. The radius of the balloon will increase. Okay? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So suppose ye hamare paas balloon tha. तुमने इसमें और एयर को पंप कर दिया, सो इट विल बिकम बिगर. तुमने और एयर को पंप कर दिया, सो इट विल बिकम एंड सो ऑन. सो इफ आई नो दैट हाउ मच एयर आई एम ब्लोइंग इनटू द बलून एंड आई वांट टू सी द चेंज इन द रेडियस, तो हाउ विल आई डू? फर्स्ट आई विल राइट द फॉर्मूला. वी व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला? 4/3 πr³.
Yeah.
Hota hai?
Yes, sir. So now we
volume
can
of the sphere. Now I will differentiate it with respect to r. So it will become dr. So 4/3 π. What will be the derivative of r³?
3r²
So this cancel. So it will become dv equal to 4πr² into
dr.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, if I divide it by dt, so ye kya hai dv by dt?
change rate of change of volume.
Rate of change of volume. This is rate of change of radius. So suppose if I say you that I am blowing air at a rate of 5 m³/s, then at what rate the radius of the sphere will increase? So see, now you know dv by dt that itna air per second increase ho raha hai air ke andar, that balloon ke andar, so the radius of the balloon will also increase, and we will put all the values here. Okay, so you all you have that a PDF of exercise?
Yes sir,
that vectors. Calculus and vectors.
Yes sir.
Just open it once and come to the lecture 3. No, 4. Lecture 4.
Yes, sir.
Now I want you to solve lecture 4. Ice. You know, in that there are question number 3, question number 4, and question number 5. Okay, these are the questions on the basis of rate of change. So just go through the question for first, or revise the notes, go through the question. If you are able to solve, very good. If you are not able to solve, it's okay. We will solve in the next class. But I want you to try it by yourself. Okay.
So which questions do we have to do again? On the tutorial or the in-class examples?
I see that my in-class example. Question 3, 4, and 5. These are on the basis of a rate of change.
Okay, sir.
Lecture 4.
Yes.
Okay. And one question I am giving you right now. Okay. Suppose there's a lamp post. There's a light. And the height of this is 20 meter. A man is here. The height of man is 2 meter. Man is going this side with a velocity 3 m/s. Okay. You have to find rate of change of length of shadow of man. ये तुमको find करना. और ये light है ना, यहाँ से आएगी light, तो man को अपना shadow ना दिखेगा ना, यहाँ पे दिखेगा shadow, ये वाला shadow. तो जैसे जैसे वो आगे जाएगा the length of the shadow will increase. तो तुमसे पूछा है कि find the rate of change of the shadow.
Sir, 2 m is the height of the man, right?
Yes, 2 m is the height of man and 20 m is the height of pole of light. So this is your homework question.
Starting from the pole, right? The man.
Huh?
The man is walking away from the pole, right, sir?
Yes, yes, it's away from the pole. See the arrow. I have made that.
Yeah, okay, sir. Yeah, got it.
Okay, everyone understood? Okay, so do this and our differentiation is over. If you have any doubt, we will do in the next class or we will start integration. Fine?
Okay, sir.
Okay, chalo. Do you have another class after this or shall I end the meeting? What?
Shall I end the meeting?
Okay, chalo, good night.